Rudy Giuliani is not the only Trump sycophant right now who is suffering. And it's so funny because these are the conservatives who love to preach go woke, go broke. No one could ever accuse Rudy Giuliani or this next guy of being woke, but both of them you could accuse of being broke because the attorneys defending Mike Lindell against defamation claims from voting machine companies want to sever ties with him because of millions of dollars, just like Rudy, and unpaid legal fees. And they filed in court on Thursday, the law firm of Parker Daniels Kybort. And they said that Lindell and MyPillow are months behind on their legal bills and three defamation cases, and that they can no longer afford to represent him. So let's take a look at a little bit of what that filing had to say. At this time, defendants are in arrears by millions of dollars to PDK. PDK is a small litigation and trial firm in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and cannot afford to finance defendants' defenses in these litigations. The firm said that if it was forced to continue providing legal services to Lindell, the future fees and costs will amount to millions of dollars in addition to the millions of dollars already owed. Lindell on Thursday praised his lawyers as brave and courageous and said he would gladly keep paying them if he wasn't broke. We've lost everything, every dime, he told NBC News in a phone interview. All of it is gone. And if you're thinking this feels like I've heard this before regarding Mike Pillow, it's because you have. This is just one of many of his financial woes. So as an example, in April, an arbitration panel ordered Lindell to pay $5 million for losing his Prove Mike Wrong 2020 election challenge, in which participants were asked to find proof that his cyber data was not valid data from the November 2020 election, as he'd contended it was. And I, going through the story, was kicking myself for not knowing about that challenge at the time. I could have been cashing in on Mike Pillow's ignorance and his stupidity. But I think the best part of these stories, Cenk, is that they literally have no one to blame but themselves for all of the things, you know, they have pushed. Misinformation, propaganda, election conspiracy lies on Rudy Giuliani's part. He literally attempted to overthrow the results of an election. If Mike Pillow had more power, I'm sure he would have done the exact same things. But fortunately, we didn't let the crack addict Pillow guy get that much access to positions of power. Although any power being held by that man is concerning. But it's, I'm glad that they're all seeing the consequences of their actions. To some extent.
Yeah, another takeaway I have from the story is that the people in power are a mirage. Like they make it seem like, meritocracy, the very top are the creme de la creme, right? Rudy Giuliani was the mayor of New York City. Mike Lindell had millions upon millions of dollars, was a successful businessman. And it turns out they're both, I mean, I'm gonna be super generous here and just call them knuckleheads. How did you not see any of this coming? Mike Lindell, you were spending endless money on this insane conspiracy theory that the 2020 election was stolen. You never had any evidence and you kept, people kept suing you. You kept losing contracts and you just kept driving straight towards that brick wall. Same thing with Giuliani. You didn't see that Trump wasn't gonna have your back? That Trump wasn't gonna pay your millions of dollars in legal fees? You didn't see that lying on his behalf wasn't gonna end well? Man, it is stunning how short-sighted and, look, if I'm being honest, unintelligent these two guys are.
And I mean, Ray, let's be clear though, Mike Lindell had close access to the government and also to claim that the election was stolen. This is why he was named for that $1.3 billion lawsuit from Dominion, right? You actually got sued by the same people that sued Fox for the same thing, lying about those machines. This is to me the best argument about Trump and everything we've seen since he's been president is argument for the workers. If I was leading a union, I would just be putting these so-called CEOs of these so-called super successful companies up and be like, there's no way in hell America believes these men are responsible for the greatness that these companies are. Pay the workers more. This is a great case that workers need to be paid more because ain't no way we can leave the world to these nut jobs at all.